Okay, I'm going to deliver. Good afternoon, my dear students. This is the 8th lecture I'm going to deliver on conduction heat transfer. And yesterday I was discussing regarding today is 25th. Okay. I was talking about the data handbook. The data handbook which I am referring may probably see this data handbook. This is the heat and mass transfer data handbook, and the author is C.P. Kodandraman and S. Subramanian. Okay, this is the data handbook I am going to refer. Go to and from page number 1 to 40, he has given the various properties of the material. This is 7th edition I am referring. Page number 1, the property values of metal at 20 degree given, and similarly the various properties also mentioned in this book which are related to the heat transfer subject up to 41. And 42 and 43 are some of the conductivity of gases and viscosity of gas with the rise in temperature also given. You can also refer to this data in book, and to know about the heat transfer subject related equations that we are going to take up. So the first equation that I used is here in the one dimensional steady state heat conduction heat transfer. He has given heat flux Q is equal to heat flow, he has given, not heat flux, heat flow. Heat flow at Q is equal to, what is the equation given? Can you notice this equation here? This is the equation. Q is equal to delta T over R divided by R. Delta T over R divided by R is given. So this can be rewritten once again, where R is equal to first slab, it is L by KA, and delta T overall is T1 minus T2 as shown in the slab. T1, T2 are given here. Can you see this? This is T1 and this is T2, and this is conductivity and this is the cross sectional area or the surface area exposed normal to the direction of heat flow, and this is the x direction, and length of the thickness of this slab is L. It is given in the figure very clearly. And if you substitute these two values, if you have to remember these two values, if you substitute these two, you will not have to remember resistance also given. By the side, you can see the R is equal to L by KA. Okay, this is given, and the temperature distribution equation also given, resistance value is also given. What else you want? You have to substitute and get the heat flow equation. Heat flow equation means if you substitute T2, T1 minus T2 in this, and this is L divided by KA. Further to simplify, you will get KA divided by L into T1 minus T2. It means little effort is required to remember the equation in this fashion. So the also is given, the equation is little blur there. The temperature distribution equation that he has given, by the side you can see, that also I am going to write here. The temperature distribution equation is T1 minus Tx, T1 minus Tx divided by T1 minus T2, T1 minus T2 is equal to X by L. This is also given, this is the temperature distribution equation, where you can replace K by Km, linear variation of thermal conductivity you will get, and delta T is the overall temperature difference in degree Celsius or in Kelvin, R is the thermal resistance in kilowatt by Kelvin by watt or degree Celsius per watt. Q is the heat flow. All the units also given here. You not have to worry about it, and then you need to understand what is that available in data handbook. What is that I have to write in the examination? The 50% of the equations and the knowledge is gained by only e-transfer. E-transfer is a very easy subject. If you know how to refer, what question they are asking, how to simplify and put it in a appropriate forum. If you learn that, I think you don't have to spend much time for that. That is what I am going to explain today class. Q is heat flow in watts. And K is the thermal conductivity in watt meter Kelvin. And area is the meter square. And thickness is meter. T1, T2, T3 are the temperatures at various locations, as X and L are the planes. And T1, T2 are the temperature at 0, X and L planes. And Km is equal to K0 1 plus of alpha. That is there in the next class. Next slide I am going to show you. See, the temperature distribution equation is here. What you have to do is, you have to simplify this, or need not have to simplify. At whatever the point of x, you want to find out, knowing the temperature. This is T1 and this is T2, this is conductivity. You know the x varies from right in this direction over the length L. At any point of x, say 1 centimeter, you can substitute 1 centimeter, and temperature of Tx can be calculated because T1, T2 are known to you. It's very easy to calculate the unknown temperature at point x, at distance x in this slab. That's what the data handbook gives. I think I made it very clear. The data handbook, this is the conduction equation, the resistance equation, and also temperature distribution equation. And related parameter with units, SI units, also given here. Okay, go to the next slide. So, here the convection heat transfer is given. This is what the fluid flowing over the surface. That is what arrow mark is shown here. The fluid is flowing over the surface. Okay, area exposed, and TW is the wall temperature, and the fluid is carrying the heat. This is called convection. This is called convection. R is equal to 1 by HA. R is equal to 1 by HA. Resistance R is equal to 1 by HA is the resistance for convection. That can be written as, the equation is, that can be written as Q is equal to HA T1 minus T2. I am writing like this. This can be written as Q is equal to T1 minus T2. This is 1 divided by HA. 1 divided by HA. This can be written as T1 minus T2. T1 minus T2 divided by R. R, where R is equal to 1 by HA. Is it clear? That is what he has given. And the mean... this variable thermal conductivity, mean conductivity, that means conductivity Km is equal to K0 1 plus alpha T1 minus T1 plus T2 divided by 2. Already the variable thermal conductivity equation I derived, that conductivity value is also given here. That is K0 1 plus or minus alpha T1 plus T2 divided by 2. Okay, and where TW is the wall temperature and T infinity is the fluid temperature. In this, he has given the wall like this, and TW is the wall temperature, and TA is the air temperature. Air is flowing over the surface like this, and this is called the convective transfer coefficient. This is the model. Modeling is done like this. Okay, similarly the radiation is equations are given. Radiation equations is given, equation is also given here with the thermal resistance, and here are the related terms are also given. When you take up the thermal radiation chapter, you can also do away with that, and I am going to cover it up there. So here the one dimensional study to heat conduction, page number 45, and this is for cylinder, and this is the resistance 1 by 2 pi kl ln R2 by R1, where R2, R1 are the radii, inner and outer radii, and T0 are the inner and outer surface temperature, and this is 1 by Ri. And the equation is directly given, you don't have to worry about it. You can, this is the temperature distribution equation, where TR is the, anywhere at R you can find out. Similarly for cylinder, this one sphere, hollow sphere, and this is the resistance. The standard equation is Q is equal to delta T divided by R. R value is given here. You can also take up this. Similarly, for the composite wall, this is the resistance for composite wall. You can also see that there are how many layers? This is the open, this is hollow, and this is first layer, second layer, third layer. Therefore, you can write R1, R2, R3, R4, and similarly we have temperature K1, K2, K3 are the conductivities, temperature T outside, T air, and you know that T1, T2, first is TI, T1, T2, T3 and T4. So these are the temperatures also mentioned here. See, for composite cylinder, the temperatures are radii, R is the radius in meter, L is the length in meter. You can see the L is given now. For unit length, always you have to do it. If the unit length you are doing it, you have to multiply. If there are 4 meters given, you can take 4 meters as the length of the cylinder and then calculate with that. So the resistance R is this, that is 1 by H naught R1. That's the outside radius if it is a, okay, and 1 by K1 ln R2 by R1, 1 by K2 ln R3 by R2 plus 1 by K3 ln R4 by R3 plus 1 by HV into R4. R4 is the outer radius and HA is the inner radius. Here HA is there and R1 is there. It means he has taken the different notation. You can also see this inside and outside. You can also use this notation. This is the resistance equation, where R is there in the standard equation, substitute and calculate the conductivity. Delta T is equal to QRI has taken right from here. Delta T1, the every page he has given the conduction equation. Therefore, Q is equal to delta T by R, where R is this. You can calculate the heat flow, and also you can know the, here we are not going to ask a temperature distribution for this. You can know the temperature distribution, you can also calculate only the heat flow through that, and what is the temperature difference, how many parameters are there. Any one parameter is unknown parameter they are going to give. In a given equation, how do you solve this problem when the problem is given? I am going to analyze those problem, and what way you have to analyze. How many parameters are given, how many unknowns are there, how to calculate the unknown by using these conduction equation. Directly I have taken these equation from data handbook and solved the problem. This is for sphere. So this is a composite sphere with the convection. Composite means it is having many layer, more than one layer is called composite. It means this is the hollow portion, first layer, second layer, and there is the interface temperature 1, 2, 3 are there. It means only one interface temperature between two layers. So the temperatures are given as T1 and Ti is inside and T0 is outside. So, and also he has given the temperature, surface temperature is T1, T2 and T3. Here T1, T2 interface and T3 is outside temperature, and also given Hi and H0. Hi is the inside heat transfer coefficient at R1 and H0 is the outside heat transfer coefficient at R4, and related equations are given like this, and the related parameter explanation also given here. fluid temperature. Delta T is equal to Q into XR. Again, Q is equal to delta T divided by R, you can take delta TI, inside temperature difference. You can also take it as outside temperature difference. With a different configuration, it is not included in yourselves. You not have to worry about it, because a square object having a circular hole. How do you take the resistance? That's also given here, and it is out of scope of your syllabus. You not have to worry about it. Coming to the composite slab, you know that there are three slabs are put together make composite slab, and the heat flow direction is also given, and it is a decreasing gradient. It is going right from left to right. From my side, it is left, and to right when it goes, this is a decreasing gradient. Interface temperature is also given. This is T1, T2, T3, T4, and this is H0, and here it is TA, and this is TG, gas temperature. So all that parameter, it means TA is inside and TB is outside, and conductivity having K1, K2, K3. Also is given. This is HA, heat transfer coefficient at phase A, heat transfer coefficient at phase B, and having L1, L2, L3. These are the nomenclature of composite plane wall with a convection at inside and outside on both the sides. So this is the resistance equation R. So where T and TB are the fluid temperature suitably at inside and outside, L1, L2 are the thickness of the layer for temperature drop in the layer uses, and delta T is Q into R. Therefore, Q is equal to delta T divided by R, where K1, K2 are the conductivity of layers 1, 2, 3. HA, HB are the convective coefficient at A and at B. May be present, may not be present, or may be given in the problem, may not be given. What is that not given? Convective boundary condition may not be given. I told you there are three boundary conditions. One is temperature boundary condition, heat flux boundary condition. Another boundary condition is that the convective boundary condition. Here the temperature boundary condition, convective boundary condition, both are given in this figure. Okay, for all figure, and very rarely they will give the heat flux boundary conditions. In such situation, how to solve that equation also I given in the previous lecture. You can go through those lectures. Okay, and here last class I discussed about electrical analogy, how to write the composite resistance in series and parallel. And you have to remember also, resistance is given in the examination. They ask the question, but write a resistance network for parallel and series resistance. If the composite wall is given like this, how to calculate that? I'll make little effort to understand whatever the values are given. I can write, and then I'll show you how it should be solved. You can also write this as answer in the examination if they ask the question. And you don't have to remember anything. Everything is given. Only thing is, one has to make a little effort in understanding this. This is the first layer. Okay, this is A. Okay. And B is having two slabs are in parallel. This is. And C is having three. 1, 2, 3. This is A, B, C. What cell is given? D, E, F. D, E, F. And one more layer is given. What is this? This layer is G layer. Heat is flowing like this, Q. And heat is going out like this, Q, and it is having a length portion, LA, LB, LC, and whatever there. This is LA, this is LB, this is LF, this is LD. It means LF is equal to LE, LD are there. You can also write this equal to LC, this equal to LD, this equal to LE, and this equal to LC. And all the lengths are equal because they are in parallel range. So in this figure, first slab resistance I am going to write, RA is equal to LA divided by KA into area, unit area we have to take. Next, RB. How to write RB is equal to? I'll take it as 1 by R, the first one, first case. Okay, 1 by RB plus 1 by RC. So you take LCM, RB, RC, whole divided by this is RC plus RB. So this is 1 by RI.
What is that he has taken? 1 by R2 he has taken, R1 and R2.
This one is R1, okay, this one is R2 in the data handbook. This one only R2 I'll write. Therefore, R2 is equal to what? R2 is equal to RB RC divided by RC plus RB. So, this equation is there in that. So, this is the equation which I am showing. Okay. Can you see this? This is R2. Resistance and R1, R2 are in series now. So, next R3. Is it okay? I got this equation. How do you write R3? Again, R3 is equal to 1 by R3 is equal to 1 by RD plus 1 by RE plus 1 by RF. Take LCM and cross multiply, you will get the equation like this. Okay. This for R4 is equal to RG. R3 is O, R4. Then A1, A2, A3, AC, R. If they are appropriately given, you have to take the area of cross section, different area of cross section. A is equal to AA is equal to AB plus AC. AG is equal to AD, AE, AM.
It means this cross sectional area is adding up all this, you will get the cross sectional area. Adding these two, you will get the cross sectional area. It means you can make appropriate arrangement while taking the area. 1 meter is given, half meter here, half meter here. If one third portion is here, one third portion is here, one third portion is here. Again, it is 1 meter square. Like that, you can take it. Okay. So, in case the convection heat, in case the convection boundary conditions are added to resistance value, then the resistance are here, the convective heat transfer inside, the area cross section A and temperature Ti is given. And here you have got temperature T1, T2, this is T3, and this is T4, and you got T5, and T0, H0, and area A. So these are the properties you can explain like that. So then the resistance are 1 by Hi into A. Another resistance is, this is R convection. R convection outside is 1 by H0 into A, here, when the air is flowing, okay, air is flowing, you can take this convective transfer. And looks very simple, you have to practice and then note down all this. Repeatedly you can use this data handbook for arranging. All the explanation also given right side. And the left side is simplified, middle of the column is given simplified equations. And figure is very well explained and neatly plotted. You can also note down the resistance values. That's very easy. So, here the resistance values are given. You can also go through that. Now coming to the steady state conduction with heat generation. Already given the derivation equation, the Q dot is the heat generation at x is equal to 0. I have taken full length as L while deriving, and he has taken full length as 2L, and L is left side and L is right side he has taken. The convective boundary condition is given here, and also he has given the T1, T wall temperature and T maximum temperature here. And is given x is equal to 0 at the center. And what is the controlling differential equation? D square T by dx square plus Q dot by K. D square T
by dx square plus q dot by k is equal to 0. This is Poisson's equation. I have solved this for L by 2 slab. Center, this is L by 2 and this is L by 2 I taken, and derived equation for maximum temperature. This is T max and this is T1 and T2. And this is the temperature maximum. This is x is equal to 0 and the heat generation q dot into A into dx I have taken there. If the elemental volume is taken, he has taken a different configuration altogether. He has taken L. You can also substitute and calculate. You will get the same answer. But thing is only the length. I have taken that as q dot 2k L square I have taken. That is, whatever the equation is given holds good. Wherever you get L, you have to put it as L by 2. Then you will get the equation. Is it not? Depends on the boundary condition, you can also derive the equation. If it is L is equal to L by 2 substitute, you will get the different equation here. Here also you will get the different equation. And how you are deciding the thickness of the wall, based on that, this equation going to be get modified. And that is your, while doing the problem solving, you can take this as appropriate substitution and then solve this equation. So this is the temperature distribution equation. So you know that the outside convection is considered, how you are going to consider, inside convection is taken, how you are going to consider, all that he has explained very clearly. And heat conduction equation again, Q is equal to delta T by R, you can use, and resistance is there, you can use. Here the Q naught is very important, with heat generation source. In the given equation, how many variables are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variables are there. Any 4 is going to give, 1 is going to ask, you can calculate that very easily. And looking at some students are very clever in writing the answers. They will go for reverse calculation. It means taking this equation, they are going to do it in a reverse direction. Till the Poisson's equation, they will come here and then do it. Forward, how they remember, we don't know. But anyway, they do it. Assume this equation going to, and don't try to patch up writing one equation at the first time. And answer is looking at the data handbook and then try to patch up in between some equations. That immediately examiner will come to know this fellow is the student who is not having knowledge. He has written, copied from data handbook, and he has written some initial equations and final equation. In between simplification is lost. If you do like that, you will definitely get 0 marks, because you are not understood the subject like that. Many clever students are there. They are going to take the controlling differential equation and the final equation. In between that, they are going to patch it up. It's very fast they are doing it. And that is also a good thing to remember. And you have to practice. Anyway, you have to practice it. Slab with, this is the asymmetric boundary condition. This is TW1, TW2, the varying boundary condition with heat generation. X is equal to minus L and plus L. It means X is equal to minus L and plus L is means positive direction and negative direction is taken. For that, he has given the derivation for this. This is page number 48. And you know that steady state induction with generation for slab only, it is mentioned, but not for cylinders and spheres, hollow sphere and hollow cylinder. If it is a problem is given, you can also solve by using these equations. Okay. Coming to the, now so far I have given the equation which you are going to refer from data handbook. I made an effort by giving it. And you may ask, if the properties are given, where do you get these properties? Properties tables are given right from page number 1 to page number 42 and 43. You can take those values right from the property table. All the material which I am using in numerical, all material properties are taken from data handbook only, and they are given here. Suppose you take a composite wall is made up of external thickness of fire brick wall 110 cm thick and inside layer of fiberglass 75 mm thick, and fiberglass is faced internally by insulating board of 25 mm thick. The coefficient of thermal conductivity for all the three materials are false. So brick work is 1.15 watt per meter Kelvin. Fiber glass is 0.04 because fiber glass is having a very low thermal conductivity. 0.04 watt per meter Kelvin. That 2.2 is there. I think how it has come, I don't know. It is square it become. But neglect that 3.2 are there. You can neglect it. Insulating board 0.06 watt per meter Kelvin. You know that brick is having a more conductivity than insulating board, and insulating board is having more conductivity than fiberglass. The surface heat transfer coefficient inside wall is 2.5 watt per meter square Kelvin, while that of the outside wall is 3.1 watts per meter square Kelvin. Determine the overall heat transfer coefficient for wall, and using the same, determine the heat loss per hour through such a wall of 4 meter height and 10 meter long. Take inside wall temperature as 27 degree, external ambient temperature as 10 degree. All that properties I noted down in the data given, and the space number 45, CP Kodandraman and S. Subramanian. So directly I have taken, this is page number 45. Go to page number 45 and select the equation for composite slab. It is given here. I make an effort to expose yourself. I think camera you may not able to. Camera is not able to focus it, but anyhow, it is there. This is the equation. What equation is taken? That is the equation. U is equal to 1/2, 1/h1, k1, k2, k3, 1/h0, and substituting you will get overall heat transfer coefficient to 0.3532 watt per meter square Kelvin. You know, here all the unit L1, L2, L3 thicknesses are taken. Here 111 because it is actually L1, L2, L3. It is wrongly typed here. The first thickness is 0.011 meter, 0.075 meter, 0.025 meter length. And collectively you will get overall heat transfer coefficient like this. This one is L1, L2, L3. Overall heat transfer coefficient U is equal to 1/2 divided by 1/h1 plus of L1 by k1 plus of L2 by k2 plus of L3 by k3 plus of 1 by h0 for unit area. This is the unit surface area I am taking, and substituting all the values you will get U is equal to 0.3 watt per meter square Kelvin. That's how I'm going to get this value. But this L1, L2, L3 are missing. I'm going to correct it. So therefore Q is equal to UA T1 minus T2. Q is equal to UA T1 minus T2. Very simple, but problem looks very lengthy one. Page number 171, the overall heat transfer coefficient equation is given. You can also take that. Page number 171, CP Kodandraman and Subramanian. So you can substitute 0.32. Area is 1, but area is given also. 10 into 4 is given. That you have to take. 10 meter by 4 meter. S is given. Multiplied by 27 minus of 10, you will get 217.5 watt or joule per second. Heat loss per hour is asked. You know that heat loss per hour, the same equation is again multiplied 217.5 joule per second is there. It should be converted into second is converted into what? It should be converted into hour. Hour means divided by 60, multiplied by 60 you have to do, and this will come up here 217.5 multiplied by 3600 whole divided by 1000. Why I am taking to convert joule into kilojoule? So the answer will be 780 kilojoule. That's all per hour. Kilojoule per hour you can also write.
So that is what you have to do. Little conversion is necessary because you need to know that most of the student will not understand the unit conversion. You have to practice and see that what is the, how do you convert joule per second into kilojoule per hour. This is what the simple conversion I did it here. Second is converted into hour, and 3600 is a in the denominator, the that is taken to the numerator, and then it is cross multiplied with the heat flow, and then divided by 1000 gives the kilowatt. It means kilojoule. Okay, another example that I given here. The composite is made up of fire clay brick, thermal conductivity 1.16. You can also write the figure for this. Magnesium insulation conductivity is 0.07 watt per meter square, and fire clay brick exposed to a temperature of 5000 degrees Celsius and magnesium insulation 50 degrees Celsius. If the thickness of the fire clay brick is 30 cm, if the interface temperature limited to 380, what should be the thickness of magnesium insulation and what should be the interface temperature if the thickness of magnesium insulation were doubled? Find the heat transfer in each case. It means this is the exam problem asked many times. But how do you calculate this? I am going to give simple equation. By selecting from data and book, all the equations are selected from data and book. Go to the data given already, it is known to you. With magnesium insulation of thickness, composite wall made of fire clay, thermal conductivity 1.0, magnesium insulation conductivity. I know you have to write figure. I am going to show you that figure there. Already you have taken that figure. See, look at the figure. This is one figure. Here L I have taken. This is magnesium fire brick and magnesium insulation, and only the L is taken. And the next case, 2L is taken, where were doubled. It means magnesium insulation double. What will be the temperature? That I am going to take it. Two cases you have to study. First one is, this is the first case, this is 30 centimeter and this is L. In the second case, 30 centimeter and this is 2L, thickness I am talking about, thickness I am talking about, okay. And how the heat transfer takes place. This is what he has asked. But Q is equal to Q by A. First heat conduction is taking place between this. What is the temperature? T1, T2 and this is T3. T1 minus T2 divided by L by KA, L by L1 divided by K1, K brick I can write. This is equal to whatever the heat conducted from this layer is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by L2 K magnesia insulation KM. For unit area is taken here. So after substituting what you get, 5000 minus 380 divided by 0.3 is the length in meter divided by the conductivity of
first material, this first material 1.16, and the second material is 0.07. Magnesium insulation is 0.07. Okay, that you have to divide it here, because I am equating the heat flow rate. I am trying to find out the L value. L2 value you get because it is 5000 minus 380, because interface temperature is given 0.03 divided by 1.16. This is equated to T2 minus T3. T2 is how much? 380. Minus T3 is how much? 50. But I don't know the length L. I can calculate L 0.07. So from these two equations, you can calculate L. L comes out to be, L1 comes out to be 0.0012 meter. This is the length of the slab L1. So similarly, you can calculate, and Q by A is, again it is heat flux, it can be written as Q. Okay, that equation I am going to use, and directly using the combined heat transfer with combined resistance L1 by K1 plus L2 by K2, I can calculate the heat flow by using this equation. This is okay. This is one form writing. It means amount of heat conducted from the first slab is equal to the amount of heat conducted in the second slab and goes out to the air. Amount of air heat conducted is equal to this, equal to this, equal to this. Like that, you can also write the equation. There is no change as such. Combinedly, we want to write Q by A is equal to small q, and T1 minus T3, directly I can take in the difference across the combined slab, divided by L1 by K1 plus L2 by K2. I can calculate Q value. Q value comes out to be 17.4339 kilowatt. So go to the next. The L value is no. If the insulation were to be doubled, that means magnesium insulation is doubled, means this insulation is 2L. 2L means multiply this value with 2L. It means 12.068 is there, 24.136 you will get. Interface temperature, again you have to calculate. The interface temperature T2 comes out to be 360.0 degrees Celsius. By substituting all the known values, T2 can be calculated. If the magnesium insulation is doubled, the temperature of this interface temperature is going to be get increased. Interface temperature means where interface temperature going to get increased. This interface temperature between two layer is going to be increased by double almost. And if the magnesium insulation double, and then L2 is equal to, you can as a 2L value, you can substitute here and get 16.88 kilowatt. It means what is the improvement that you are observing here? The 17.94 kilowatt value is getting reduced to 16.88 kilowatt. It means if the insulation increases, the heat flow is also getting reduced. That is the meaningful understanding, isn't it? The Q value is first with the single insulation, it is 17. With the double insulation, you will get 16.88 kilowatt. It means there is a reduction in heat flow when length is increased. Length is increased L2 to L. That is the appreciable achievement. And you have to understand this. When the thickness of insulation increases, heat flow going to be get reduced. Okay. Coming to the next problem. So, thermal resistance concept and its importance. See, the thermal resistance concept and importance, they may ask some questions. And I given analogy between the heat conduction and electrical, heat conduction, electrical system and hydraulic system. I made some effort to understand. See, how do you know that current circuit already know, hydraulic flow through pipes also you understand, because you have studied fluid mechanics, and also heat transfer you are studying. So directly I'll come to this electrical analogy and explain to you. It is there, okay. Electrical circuit, if we take,
this is the resistance we are going to put it. And you are going to measure the voltage here. Which the voltage potential is across, you can put the voltmeter, you can refer it. That is a voltage. And this is the resistance. Flow of current is I like this.
Okay, this is electrical circuit.
Voltage is
potential. Voltage is potential. R is resistance.
The current is flowing through this. Current is flowing through this. Okay. You know, what is the equation that you are going to write? Current is equal to voltage into resistance or what?
R is equal to V by I. I by V.
It means current is always in amps, no?
1 minute, I'll get confused.
Q is equal to V by R. That is, I is equal to V by R. Correct? And V is equal to I into R.
This is the one circuit.
Another is
another circuit which I have written is the flow of water in a pipe.
This is the pressure meter and this is the wall. Water is flowing through this and it is having a pressure difference across two points. Here one pressure. This is P1, this is P2 and this is the resistance R and V is the volume flow.
So voltage is refers to the pressure P1 and P2. Refers to as V1 and V2 and Q, the discharge is referred. Q is the discharge refers to as current and R is the resistance of the wall. That is how the electrical analogy is written.
And similarly for slab of heat transfer, the Q is this and temperature difference is the potential, that is voltage. T1, T2 are the voltage and Q is the current. And resistance R is the flow of
heat through this slab is called as a resistance, that is L by R you are going to take. So, L by K you are going to take it as a resistance because thermal conductivity is property of the material is taken.
So, therefore, how can write the electrical Q is equal to T1 minus T2, this is voltage divided by resistance. If you write I, this volt by resistance,
that also can be taken, converted. Three electrical analogies for electrical, hydraulic and thermal energy are taken and I solved it. You can also refer it. If they ask questions, you can write on this also. So the one more problem which I am stalled, steel. Steel tube is covered with a layer of asbestos insulation material. Because why I solved the composite material is resistance in series is asked, meaning that you may ask composite material also, composite cylinder also, composite sphere also, because they are in series and there also the parallel resistance also can be taken. Depend on the situation you are going to analyze and become very complex. That is why he has given only numerical example, resistance in series and parallel for this slab. So that is what time is, I think yesterday I have taken more than 15 minutes extra last hour. I am going to wind up after seeing, after showing this problem. So these are the properties are given, R1, R2, R3, R4 and T1 and TI, T0 also given. The HI, K1, K2 and H0 is also given. This is the configuration. And the boundary conditions are convective boundary condition, temperature boundary conditions are given. This is the overall heat transfer coefficient based on the outside surface area. It is given in page number 171. Directly take that equation, substitute it, get the overall heat transfer coefficient. And after getting that, you can also calculate the Q, temperature difference for the first layer. In steel tube, what is the heat flow And also in aspect as what is the heat flow, after that you can get the temperature difference for the steel tube to outside delta T1 and delta T2, you can get it. And this is the value assessed, and I solved this problem. With this, I am going to wind up this class. There are 40 slides I have made, and I am not able to tell you. Next class, I am going to cover all these problems. And tomorrow and day after tomorrow, I am going to touch upon all the exam problems. Possibly, this is the 40th slide. I am going to, because various different problems with the variable bound, with various boundary conditions, I am going to solve these problems. Okay. With this, I thank all the students for having attended my class. Thank you very much.